Hello, this is a new educational video. Some people ask me again how I do that to combine photos together. So I could not find it anymore on YouTube, but I showed one time more. So here I selected three photos. This one, the great tit on the tree, the squirrel on the yeah, with the letter in the the hands, you can say, and this one, I want to get together. So I select them all three, right click on the mouse, then go to edit in, open as layers in Photoshop. I already had keywords and that kind of things in Lightroom, so there's a lot of things already are done in the meta information. Here you see the layers on appear in the left side, and if you cannot find it there, then here in the window there you have options where you can arrange how you fix the left side of your window. But okay, all the three are here on the left side. I select them all and I say align. I created already actions here, but you can do it here. Auto align layers, auto and auto. We wait a little. So now we have all three photos together. They are arranged in exactly the same position of the mailbox. I go to the first photo. You see, that's the one with the tree. I make that black. It's like I don't know how to explain, but it's a black layer, and the left on the Alt and the left button on this little thing, and then you get a black layer over the photo. So the photo is still there. If I disable, the photo is still there. It did not disappear. I only put something black over it. Enable. So for black, I need a brush, a white brush, and here you see it's white. And if you click on the right side button, you see I do the hardness 0, and then I paint the bird black, a little bit of the snow also. Okay, that's the first photo. Then we have the squirrel, and what I want, everything here, and I want that bird and of course the squirrel. So what I have to do, I make in this case why not, maybe a black layer also. So Alt left button. And okay, I think that's a good idea. I create a little bit more, so if I go back to the first one, create a little bit more white here. Okay, then we go to the squirrel, where's the big black layer. I need a white brush, and I bring, when you do white, it brings back the parts of the photo that I paint in with white. So you can almost say the photo, I put a black layer, and then the black layer, the parts I let disappear with a white brush, that parts of the photo are visible again. Let's explain it like this. I hope you understand what I'm doing there. So I paint it back. And that's it. That's all I needed to do. Of course, then we cut a little bit. So I go Control O to have everything visible. I put something about there. I like this ending of the. I like it so. So I leave it like this. And you see, I missed something there, so it needs a white brush. I missed something in the right corner. It needs a white brush also. And I can paint in a little bit here. That's it. That's about it. Okay. Now, what I do, I flatten the image because everything is okay. I of course, I have to check if... if that went okay with the, yeah, it looks very good. Here's the different photos coming in each other. So I check a little bit if the lines are good. You see here, it looks very good. Okay, I flatten the photo. You do it here, flatten. Then you see I missed there a little bit. And I make it a little bit larger with the Control Plus. I use this lasso. Go here, there, where I missed it there. This bucket I want to have away. Double click. And if you go to fill, content awareness to 100%. Okay. And then he's searching for things what looks a little bit similar, and then he's making itself. Sometimes it's going completely wrong, but in this case, I have a big chance that everything is going good in one time. You see? Control D, then you take away the selection. That's it. Yeah, this is the photo. So a little bit details. Details. I want to have the dirt gone like this. Like this. And so that's the clone tool. That tool. You go to here. You decide. This looks a little bit similar. You click left. And then you brush over it. Same here. Click left with the Alt and the mouse left mouse button. It's a little bit like, almost like painting. And you see here. That's not nice. And it was a little bit, I saw that on the left side of the. That's it. This was the video, this time for the Patreon members, advanced members of premium members. And thanks for watching, and I hope you learn something and understand what I did this time. Thanks for watching. Bye.